Pentecost is that we celebrate the descent of the Holy Spirit, the Holy Ghost, upon the apostles, and we heard that portion of Scripture this day. Now, in the collect, we petition for God to give us the things that He has offered to us, the three things that God gives us at Pentecost and the gift of the Holy Ghost. The first thing is, He gives us the light of the Holy Spirit. Number two, we petition for and we receive a right judgment in all things in life. And number three, because of those two things, we have an unbelievable joy in His comfort and His strength. First, the light of the Holy Spirit. Do you remember when we did new halogen lights in the church? And we looked at that, we looked at various and sundry types of lights and everything, and we decided on halogens because they were bright and clear and clean. And some would say, well, why did you have to put new lights in the church? The answer is simple, to see better, because sometimes we don't see all that well, huh? Now, it's almost as if Isaiah knew the truth of the matter, that the people that walked in darkness have seen a great light, the halogen lights, huh? They that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them has the light shined, God's presence. You see, hearts are taught by the light of the Holy Spirit, okay? Without that, we would stumble around like a blind man in a new room. We would be a bunch of dim bulbs trying to make sense of the shadows of our mind, and we wouldn't do a very good job of it, to say the least. The light of the Holy Spirit is ours, and we can see things much more clearly because of the action of Pentecost Sunday and the Holy Ghost coming into our midst. By the Holy Ghost, then, we have a right judgment in all things. That's number two. I think we all understand that life is a never-ending sequence of choices. Every day we get new choices that we have to make. Some we kind of ignore, but we do have choices daily. We come to a fork in the road of life, and we can make the proper choice. That's one of the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Now, when we goof up, which we do because we're human and we think about other things instead of what we ought to be thinking about, when we goof up, we don't have to repeat the same old dumb mistake next time. You know? We have a right judgment in all things, and God has given it to us. We're smarter than we act at times. So we have a light of the Holy Spirit in our life. We have a right judgment in all things. And when we possess those things and immerse ourselves in them, then glorious things will happen in our life. We will be joyous in life. If you ever have an overriding sense of joy inside, it will be obvious to other people as you walk through this life. Here's my example. Watch my face, okay? With a frown, you know what I have on the inside. You know who I am on the inside. But with a smile and a jovial laugh, you know what I am inside. What is within spills out by way of words and deeds. That's the truth, and we all know that. We have the light of His presence. We have a right judgment in all things. Therefore, when we embrace the gifts that have been given to us because we are followers of Christ, we can evermore rejoice in His holy comfort, as the words of the collect puts it pithily. Now, we look to the gospel narrative. Jesus had instructed all of his disciples. He told them everything, and he finally said, "If a man love me, he will keep my words. My Father will love him, and we will come unto him and make our abode with him." The Comforter, he said, the Holy Ghost, shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance whatsoever I have said unto you. The Comforter has. The Comforter is teaching us. The Comforter will teach us. Now, admittedly, we don't know it all yet, but we are on our way with God at our side.